afternoon, South Africa, and a very, very warm welcome to you. My name is Jeannie D, and this is Afternoon Express. Now, self-expression through the garments you adorn your body with has to be the highest form of self-love. And today on the show, we meet fashion designer Hugo Fleur, as well as brand manager Dennis Hammer of the fashion brand Hugo Fleur. So they will be showcasing their uniquely printed, really luxurious Italian linen with a modern yet classic style on Fashion Express today. Plus, tech expert TNS Janssen van Rensburg is back, and he's going to be demystifying TV panel technology as he explains the differences between the types of TVs available on the market. Then we chat to Sabric CEO Kalyani Pillay about how we can avoid becoming victims of holiday scams by securing our car details by using 3D secure technology. Plus, you can connect with us on our social media platforms and tell us what your current favorite fashion trend is. So tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the official hashtag Afternoon Express or comment on our Facebook page.
Good afternoon, South Africa. My name is Palisa Dembe, and here on Afternoon Express, you know we bring you nothing but the best in the kitchen. But today we're taking it local because local is, of course, Lekker with Chef Aya. Chef Aya?
Yeah.
I see in choco, I see a scope, I see a head.
Are you as excited as I am?
I am excited. What are we having today?
So today we're basically going to take what we normally like, one of South Africa's favorite, which is a sheep head. And I grew up eating that a lot. And we're going to be serving it with a beautiful tombolo on the side. So we're going to be making a beautiful, nice tomato stew with it. It's going to be amazing. It's going to fall off the bone. I'll just...
It sounds amazing. I mean, every single time I enjoy sheep's head, it just gives me a little shot of home, a little throwback to home, nostalgic memories, of course. So to try the sheep's head, of course, at home, SMS the keyword EATS to 33650, and we will be pairing it with a delicious dombolo. So if you would like some dombolo, of course, paired with your Clover Manhattan iced tea, SMS the keyword Clover to 33650. And Chef Aya, speaking of Clover Manhattan iced tea, can you imagine what it would be like to shop until you drop with 100,000 Rand at Sandton City? Well, we will be spilling all the iced tea on how you can stand a chance to win these fabulous prizes a little later on in the show. We hope that you've been collecting those Manhattan dollars to shop online Manhattan style, of course, on the Manhattan store for the next shopping window from the 29th of May to the 31st of May. There are so many amazing prizes available to purchase during the shopping window. So we want to know from you, what would you be shopping with your Manhattan dollars? So make a vote on our Twitter poll and go to Afternoon Express at Afternoon Chat and tell us and let us know. Chef Aya, what would you like? We've got bags, we've got fragrances, vouchers.
Do you know, when I went online store, I saw everything else. And then once I bumped into the Lucrece set, I was like, you know what? Everything else for now on the side, I'll go for those ports.
And especially because Lucrece is quite expensive, I would definitely use my Manhattan dollars on the same.
That's correct.
We can agree. Whilst we're agreeing, over to you, Jeannie.
It's an add to cart kind of day, so stand a chance to win your share of 1 million rand with Manhattan iced tea. Shop online in April and May at www.shopmanhattanstyle.co.za to be entered into the grand prize draw of a shopping experience in Sandton City. The winners will be announced on 5FM's Tabuti Drive in June. Buy any Manhattan 500ml or 1.5 litre promotional pack. Redeem your code from under the label and earn your virtual Manhattan dollars. Ready, set, shop!
Now, Dladla Mshunqisi rose to fame after a video of him singing a gimmick called Navara circulated on social media. Soon after that, his music career catapulted after he collaborated on a song called Memeza with Benny Maverick. He has now become an award-winning gqom vocalist with numerous smash hits under his belt. Let's have a look at one of the videos that made him famous. To have you here.
Thank you very much for having me.
You basically look like you are the most fun person to go to a party with.
Trust me, you got that right.
And then when I look at some of your work, you basically the DJ Khaled of South Africa.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
So how did your career start? Because you just rose to fame, like, all of a sudden out of nowhere, and made Durban a party capital.
It was quite a mission to start this career, because I wasn't sure if, am I ready? Am I supposed to be going on music? Because yeah. I was just a businessman working on normal days. I've got a catering company. I was cooking for events. I was hosting events. So then Benny Maverick came along. And then he said, listen, let's go on studio and see what can happen. And then Memeza came along.
Amazing. And what does it actually mean? Like, what are the things that you're saying when you are hyping?
It's different things. I can even say a hub song about you, anything in front of me.
Absolutely. I've always wanted my own hype song. Would you be able to just do it off the cuff? Yes.
If you fail, sumu hambe afternoon express. If you fail, sumu hambe. Hey, mo sumu.
Okay, now you're gonna have to translate that. Okay. What does it mean?
Afternoon express. Get up. It's time for afternoon express. If you fail, sumu hambe. Let's get up and go to afternoon express.
Oh, that is amazing. Yeah. Thank you very much. I've always wanted my own hype man.
You've got one now.
So your life started off with you wanting to be in the kitchen. So you had your own catering company, you were cooking. What was your speciality?
African cuisine, African food.
Really?
Yeah, I heard they were talking about amadombolo.
They're making smileys in the kitchen.
That is amadombolo.
I don't think anything in life is. I don't know if that's worth smiling
that's
about.
That's one of my best dishes.
Is it really?
I love amadombolo, yes.
Oh, that's amazing. Well, that's why we're making it today, just
thank
for you.
Thank you.
So now, from that, you were obviously a very, very successful businessman. Yeah. And then now, are you doing music full-time?
Yes, I'm doing music full-time. I'm under Afrotainment, DJ D.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm leaving
music.
I
heard that your parents freaked out a bit when you told them that you were going to be a full-time
You know how a parent, you know when they send you to school, they expect you to be, you know, that exactly. Yeah. So, and then being in the music, they were like, hey, Bo, where are you going to get the money from? There's money in music. You live, it's nice, it's the best. And then now they can see because of all the fruits, all the things that I'm getting off from the music industry.
So now that the money's coming in, they are hella
supportive.
Yeah,
they're very happy. They support me every time.
Do they go to your gigs?
My sisters do, sisters, brothers. We've got quite a large family. Yeah, they do. But they've seen me perform before.
Yeah. Mm. So now, what does your life look like now? Like, what do you do during the day? And then how often are you gigging?
We gig every weekend.
Amazing.
We gig every weekend. If I'm not doing anything, I'm always in studio. I'm always with DJ Dira. I'm doing music. I'm always with the team, Tipsy, Beast, everyone from Afrotainment. Yeah. It's music every day.
Yeah, what a beautiful life.
It's the best.
So tell us a little bit about your debut album.
Mshunqo.
Mshunqo. Did I say that right?
Yes.
Mshunqo.
Mshunqo. Yes. Because you got the right. Mshunqo, it came. I wasn't sure. For me, I was like telling Utira, I'm ready to have an album. And then Utira was, you just came. You know, he wasn't that sure. But then he knew that I could pull it off. And then that's what we did. It was Sleepless Nights with my executive producer, Usenzo. Shout out to Usenzo. He never sleeps. We did the album, the way people loved the album, the way people were buying my album. Thank you very much for the continuous support. They're still buying the album. It's a Mshunqo album. Mshunqo is when it's lit, it's starting to get lit. There's going to be a fire night tonight. So Mshunqo is just having fun.
Yeah, amazing. Yes. But I heard that you've still got aspirations to one day open a restaurant.
Definitely, definitely. I'm looking forward to having my own restaurant and I'm working on that. Obviously, I'm going to start from Ekaslam, which is Kwamashu back in Durban. Yeah. I'm looking forward to having a kitchen because I want to cook entertain people, cook and entertain.
Yeah, you need a kitchen and a stage,
yes,
all in one
definitely,
go.
Definitely, yes.
How did you end up meeting Tira?
I met Tira when we were doing Omonye. Yeah. Remember the song that took Song of the Year, Omonye, in the summers? Oh, summers.
Summers this year are going to be the best.
They're going to be the best
ever.
I'm nominated.
It's like 25 years of summers, so
and
this year is going to be incredible.
With the nomination, I know they're going to be best. People, please vote for me. Yes, I know they're going to vote.
Have you already planned your thank you speech, if you will?
Yes.
Your acceptance
I've got
speech.
My thank you speech ready. Trust
Amazing.
Me.
Thank you so much for being here today. We're looking forward to your performance and best of luck for the Samas. Please vote.
Thank you for having me.
Please vote indeed. Memeza Mshunqisi Silalele, you're about to set the Afternoon Express loft on fire a little later on in the show with your incredible performance. Engage with us on social media. Let us know your thoughts, any words of wisdom, any questions for Mshunqisi, let us know. And we also want to find out from you, if you were to shop Manhattan style worth 100,000 rand at Tansen City, what would you purchase? Go over to our Twitter poll and make your vote. So after the break, we prepare a tasty sheep smiley stew, which is an original recipe created by our very own Afternoon Express chefs. Plus, we chat to tech expert TNS Janssen van Rensburg about the differences between the types of TVs. And then we chat to Sabric CEO Kelyani Pillay about how we can avoid becoming victims of holiday scams. See you after the break. welcome back to Afternoon Express. Now, what can be more comforting than a good slow-cooked stew? With our hearty stew is made with the tender bits of sheep's head. Yes, you heard me right. We are enjoying sheep's head meat, and we are taking local liquor to the very next level with this fusion of flavors. So join in on the fun and SMS the keyword EAT to 33650 to get the list of ingredients and recipe. Now, we are going major in the kitchen, doing something that we've never done on Afternoon Express, but it is so popular in South Africa. Very. It is what the people want, and we are giving you exactly that. We are preparing inhloko.
Some of them call them iskobo, yeah. It has different names.
Okay, so what goes into this?
So basically, we are going to be making the iskobo stew, and basically I'm going to do the sauce on the side, because you know how long the iskobo takes to take.
How long?
It takes about 4 to 5 hours slow cooking. So basically what you do, you go to the butcher or whatever meat store you have, you get the iskobo. Some of them are cleaned already, but what I do when I get home, I like to boil it in hot boiling water for like 10 to 20 seconds just to get off all those excess dirt in them, like the nose and ears, and then after that back into a fresh boiling water, and then you just boil it for like 4 hours.
Okay.
You can add salt, or you can add chicken stock.
You can kind of flavor as
Yeah, but you don't have to, because you know what we do at the end of the day, you just take it out in the plate with your parents, and then you just have salt on the side, and you just keep it.
And you kind of dip, and yeah, this is so this is the meat that comes from the different pieces
of
the head.
That's correct. That's correct. So it's more like a pulled sheep's head.
I love that. Let's construct our stew.
So now I'm going to start with the stew. I've got a pot here, which is already on medium heat. My olive oil in there. Some onions.
You've got your onions, you've got your carrots, your raw carrots.
Some carrots and garlic.
Love a good garlicky stew.
So the reason why I'm also doing the sauce on the side, the meat will take, as I said, it will take 4 hours to cook, and this will take less than an hour. So you don't want your veggies to overcook and everything become mushy on your plate.
Of course.
So now I'm gonna add my garlic here and finish off with my chili.
Brilliant. So it's ideal to start, of course, with the meat whilst the meat is cooking. And then the meat is about an hour out.
Yeah.
Then you start with the stew and you get the stew going.
But also, if you want to do like a one pot wonder, you can do this in a big pot, and then you just have all your raw ingredients in here, and then you put it in the oven with your liquid. And then once you're done, you can strain your juices out.
Brilliant.
And then you take your scobble out, and then you use the sauce, you know, on the side, you reduce it, it becomes thick and very nice. Because you must also remember, the more you reduce your salt, your stock, or whatever liquids you're cooking, the saltier it becomes.
Nice.
So that helps out a lot, and then you can just cook your different veggies on the side.
We are enjoying this sheep's head in a way we've never enjoyed it before here with the stew. I want to find out from you at home, how do you like to enjoy your sheep's head? Tweet us, Instagram us, Facebook us. I want to find out. Over here, it looks like we're taking this recipe to private school, because we're enjoying a sheep's head like we've never done before. And later on, we're pairing it with a delicious dombolo. But honestly, you can use anything to pair it with, any carb, any starch, or enjoy as is. I love to enjoy meat as is. I don't want anything to interrupt with my flavors.
Exactly.
The simpler, the better for me.
So you see also what you just said now. I love what you just said. We cook this on the side, and then we cook the scobo on the side with just plain water. So also, you don't take away the idea of having a scobo. So the original flavors are all in there. You know what I mean? So what's going to happen, you're just going to pull the pork, I mean the sheep heads, and then we're going to plate it on top of our stew sauce, you know. So now you don't get to lose the original flavor of the scobo.
That sounds amazing. I mean, we're finishing off this dish a little later on in the show, where we are, of course, going to be making it with a delicious, succulent dombolo, which is steamed bread for our viewers at home who are not familiar with it. I mean, at home, we just kind of take the entire head, we steam it, put it straight on a sharing, kind of like this, kind of like a chopping board.
Yep.
And the family just digs in. We find it like a nice bonding experience. You know how they say.
But tell me, have you guys ever made it from scratch yourselves at home?
I've never made it at home. But if you want to make this recipe at home from scratch, SMS the keyword EATS to 33650. Whilst Aya is putting the finishing touches on our stew. Over to you, Jeannie.
Now, this week, we've been taking a closer look at what makes LG's OLED technology a cut above the rest when it comes to TV quality. Now, the problem is that there are so many different TVs on the market in different price brackets that it can easily get confusing when you walk into the store. So here to demystify everything for us is tech expert Tienus Janssen van Rensburg. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much for having me.
So I am actually looking for a new TV at the moment, but you just walk in, and there's every kind of TV on the wall, and then I don't quite know. Like, I know a while back, HD was what we had to look for, but now there's UHD or UHD, SUHD. I mean, what does that even mean? What are the differences between them?
Right, so these all have to do with the quality of the image that you're seeing, right? So UHD is a kind of a step up from HD. So a couple of years ago, we for the first time had HD, yeah, which technically is 1080p, which means on the longer side of the TV, you've got 1080 pixels, essentially.
Okay.
Now the technology has advanced, meaning that we can actually squeeze better image quality into the same size package. So now UHD, ultra high definition, means that we can basically double or quadruple the amount of pixels we can squeeze into the same size screen, which is such amazing image quality now that, you know, the human eye is starting to struggle to differentiate that from what the world actually looks like.
No ways, that is incredible.
It's moving so quickly.
So last week we reviewed the nano cell. Is that the equivalent in the UHD?
Not quite. So the nano cell is an LCD display. So okay, now we're talking about different technologies here. So with LG, we've got different technologies. So the nano cell uses LCD,
okay,
and it goes up to the OLED displays, the OLED displays, which okay, is the higher technology, the newest technology that is basically pushing image quality, not only in density, like yeah, HD to UHD, but also the image quality in terms of LCD to OLED.
So what is the difference between OLED and LCD?
Yeah, so this is where people get confused quite
so
easily.
I'm so confused.
Well, look, it's not really confusing.
There's OLED and then LCD. What's the difference between the two?
Right, so LCD stands for liquid crystal display.
Okay.
And it's kind of the previous generation of technology that we've now obviously refined, and it's become really, really good with the nanocell technology from LG.
Okay.
But OLED is the newest technology that all the big TV companies are now starting to use, because it's kind of the next step, right? It's the next level. And we've looked at some OLED TVs on the show before,
yeah,
and they are just a grade above.
Okay.
The reason why OLED is so different from LCD is because of the fact that you can pack so much more quality of image, not only the quantity in terms of the pixels that you're showing the consumer, but the quality of image is so much better, because you don't need, first of all, the backlight that you need for an LCD, which means the darker images are darker.
Exactly,
you know, you've got
because
true
there's lots
black
of little lights as opposed to one main.
Exactly. So okay, so it's kind of like one of these big studio lights, which is just a big light wow in the background, and that's kind of what you had with LCD.
Okay.
With OLED, you've got every single pixel can light itself.
Amazing.
So when it's switched off, when there's no electricity running through the conductor, it's completely switched off, and that's why you get that really
true
rich,
black,
dark display that you actually want to see. You know, if we had that with Game of Thrones that came out a couple of weeks ago.
I know. I was thinking that. So when it comes to, like, the best that you can get, that's then OLED.
OLED is the way to go.
Okay.
It's the newest technology. And what is great is, because technology moves so quickly, the prices drop really quickly, right? So you can now pay 100,000 Rand for a super high-end 80-inch OLED, but I can bet you in a year or two, it's going to be 10% of that. You're going to pay what you pay now for an LCD in a couple of years, what you can pay for the top end. So that's where we're heading. And even when you come down in the scale, you can get a really, really good OLED display for a really good price, which is great.
Okay, amazing. That's what I'm doing. So currently LG is running a fantastic promotion where you'll get free delivery and installation for selected OLED TVs. T's and C's do apply. And if you want more information, make sure you visit lg.com/ZA.
With self-lighting pixels, only OLED TVs make perfect black. And perfect black creates perfect color. LG OLED TV.
With all these holidays amongst us, I'm sure that we're all searching for that next great special to take our holiday plans to the next level, or that bargain that we simply cannot resist. But more often than not, these deals are too good to be true. Now, Sabric CEO Kalyani Pillay is back in the loft to help us avoid being another holiday scam victim. Welcome back to the loft. You know, I absolutely love these moments that we get to bond and connect, because more than anything, I'm learning. I love a good bargain. I'm not sure about our viewers out there. But how do we know what's real and what to engage in and what is a complete scam?
I think, Palesa, everybody's looking out to get some kind of bargain. And why not? You know, absolutely. So I think the thing that everybody needs to be very mindful of is, for one, don't be too emotional and don't get so excited when you see this absolute bargain and this great special. Mm. just bear in the back of your mind that it could possibly be a scam. And most often they are, especially when it's really such a great deal. Mm. So the important thing that we say to people is it's very difficult to detect sometimes, but what the perpetrators actually do, they organize syndicates. They create fake websites. Wow. And when you go onto that website, it of course offer you great prices for air tickets, wonderful accommodation, additional packages to go with it if you want to have meals with it.
All and the all convenience. Kinds
of, absolutely. And of course you get completely sucked in, and that's what happens to most people. And so this is really, again, about social engineering. And so we're saying to bank customers, please be on the lookout for the fact that these specials could actually be part of a whole hoax. Yeah. You know, go onto the URL once you're on the web page, put your cursor on it, and if it changes, then you know immediately that you're on a fake website. You know, that's one of the things. Okay. Look out for HTTPS again. Very important, because when you book this accommodation or travel
flights.
Tickets, you would need to make a payment, because that's what it's about, is that they want your money. Mm-hmm. So make sure that you're on a secure site, because they would need to obtain those certificates in order to be registered. So just, it's not the only thing you should be looking out for, because perpetrators now are trying to even mimic that. But these are all the things that you need to start looking out for. So also contact the company. If there's a telephone number, don't phone the number that's on the website or on the advert that you receive, but try and do a search yourself for that particular company and try and find out. But, you know, we're saying to bank customers, because you're going to be paying, you should make sure that you look out for the other security features that will help you, your double level of authentication, like 3D Secure. Very important to register or to enable your payment system so that you get 3D Secure authentication as well.
What is 3D Secure, and how does one register to become make sure that you're safe?
So what happens is that most often banks have already built it into the offerings to their clients. Mm. But if you go onto your bank's website, yourself, so type into the URL, your bank's web address, go in, you'll be able to download 3D Secure so that you have this functionality when you're making payments. What actually happens with it is that it's a second level of authentication. So when you put in your card details on this website, which of course by then you should already have checked for all the security features, when you're making the payment, then you put in your card details and you click the button to say pay. Mm. Then you'll get a second screen coming up which has a window on it which will ask for a one-time password.
Yes, the OTP.
And what will happen is that the one-time password will usually be sent to, most often to your mobile phone. Then you put that in. So that's another level of authentication.
What other factors are most identifiable that we can kind of set the alarm bells ringing?
Well, you know, again, if it is an absolute special or a bargain, look out for that. Be suspicious immediately. You know, really, it's so important, because it's so difficult to get your money back. Because you could book holiday accommodation and go to the place and find that you actually don't have it. You won't get any confirmations. You may be expecting travel tickets, you're not going to get them. And then you can't find the person, because it's all behind, it's faceless people, and you don't actually then know who you're dealing with, and it makes investigations very difficult. So just, you know, I would also encourage the viewers to go onto the SABRIC website, which is www.sabric.co.za. Mm-hmm. And if you click under Stay Safe, you will see under holiday scams all the information that you should constantly remind yourself on.
I love that. Kelyani, lastly, unfortunately, you found yourself a victim. What does one do? How can you make sure that you escape and get everything that's been taken from you back?
That's unfortunately, you know, the difficult part of it, because once you've paid, it's very difficult to get your bank to even recall that, because the payment's already gone. So, but you should notify your bank, and you obviously have to notify the police. Unfortunately, investigation is extremely difficult. But if for any reason the payment's not, you know, not taken out of the account to which it went, it's possible that, you know, it can be stopped. But most often it's too late. So rather take all the precautions beforehand than become a victim of it.
prevention is better than cure. Thank Absolutely. You so much, Kellyanne, for coming through. A whopping 8,254 SIM swap incidences were reported in 2018 in South Africa, and that number is just increasing. So join us next week where SABRIC CEO Kellyanne gives us tips on how to avoid becoming a victim of fraud.
We are brave, innovative, everywhere. We are SABRIC.
So, of course, it is a Fashion Express Thursday, and we are asking you, what are your favourite trends at the moment? So, Palesa Selanes is jeans, ponchos, boots and tracksuits. I absolutely love a good poncho. Then Nsoaki Matela says knee-high boots, fur jackets and a nice pair of jeans. Well, definitely faux fur. And then Lorato says tailor-made fitted suits with polo necks plus loafers and polished shoes. Lovely. You all sound super stylish. Now, after the break, we prepare another South African favourite, a steamed pot bread, also known as edimbolo, I think. it goes nicely, apparently, with the tasty sheep smiley stew. So we'll be right back baking that after the break. Express
Enjoy full fruit flavor in Ceylon or green tea varieties of Manhattan iced tea. Made with love by Clover.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express, where we're celebrating all things African in the kitchen, it being, of course, African Month. We want you to try the recipes, of course, along with us at home. Now, if you have not yet been collecting your Manhattan dollars, where have you been? The next shopping window to shop Manhattan style with your dollars, of course, on the online store is the 29th to the 31st of May. Now, there are many fabulous items to shop for, such as bags, shoes, and fragrances. So we want to know from you, what would you be spending your Manhattan dollars on? Chef Aya, what would you use?
You know, as I said what I said, that I'm getting a lucrative port. But now that also I know there's a YouTube roulette, why not, like, throw one?
Right? Down. Chef Aya's like, I said what I said. It's between a Le Creuset pot, of course, and that Nutribullet, yeah, which I personally love. But first, a quick recipe with one of the items that you can also shop for online on the online Manhattan store, which is, of course, the Le Creuset pot, which is incredible. I'm loving it. But first, what are we making in the pot?
Dombolo. Can you do it?
I can do it. Okay, one, two, one, two. Dombolo.
dombolo. We are making
to save my life,
we are making a dombolo. You might not be able to dance the dombolo, but you can make a dombolo perfectly well. What goes into this dombolo?
So quickly, we're going to be starting with our dombolo mixture, which I have my 350 grams of normal flour here,
okay.
My sugar and salt together in there. I'm going to mix these with my dry yeast as well in here.
Delicious, okay.
So this is basically the same recipe as you'd have at home when you're making a makwinya or a normal bread at home. And then while I'm mixing that, I'm going to add in here my garlic first, sorry.
Okay, your garlic.
Yeah,
hey,
so that
I'm
we,
getting
yeah,
ahead
I mean,
myself.
We
I'm
can't have normal bread. You know, we're trying to elevate this recipe.
I've actually never had some garlic and herbs in idombolo. I want to know how you prepare your dombolo. Some people put cheese, some people put a whole lot of stuff in idombolo to make it, of course, richer, to make it full of flavor. And, of course, we have to put that South African stamp on it, which is local, is lekker.
So now I've got 250 mils of water here with 15 mils of oil.
Okay.
So I'm going to mix this together, and then later on, you knead it when you're done mixing it through. You knead it, and then in the oven, like, well, your oven must be like on 20 just to get that nice heat to help you raise your dough.
Okay. So whilst you're mixing it up, it ends up looking a little something like this.
Well, after 2 hours or 3 hours in the warm space, it looks like this. So what we're going to do now, I'm just going to knead it quickly.
I want to help you. I want to kind of get involved because I love idombolo, but I've actually never made one. I am not proud
I'll
of that. I'm definitely not proud of that, Chef Aya. But the way I like idombolo lamb is not cooked fully through. I know it's quite nice, fluffy and full of life, but I like mine a little raw. I don't know if there's like a
What do you mean a little raw?
Yes, my grandmother used to not cook the idombolo through completely, and then she used to leave it a little bit, I don't know the terminology.
I've never heard it like that. You know what, what I know about the raw doughs, a lot of people like them, it's like your cookie doughs.
Yes.
Were you one of those who also love those?
Who loves the cookie dough. And of course, to pair this, to put it all down, wash this all down, we're washing it down with our Clover Manhattan iced tea. Which leads me to the keyword. If you want to try this recipe at home, SMS the keyword Clover to 33650. And I don't know if I'm doing a good job.
No, that's fine. You know, another thing a lot of people get worried about is, so you know, you just squeeze it out like that.
Okay. Oh, and that
And then you
kind of
get a circle. Yes. So what
I
do you want to do? We're going to put them in our steam pots for like 15 to 20 minutes.
Okay.
But we're doing like smaller sizes now. It's going to be like
And obviously
10 minutes.
Using your liquid pots. We're celebrating African Month this month and African Day, which is coming up on Saturday, which is why we're keeping it local as lekker. We're making Dladla Mshunqisi's favorite idombolo. And of course, if you want to try this again, SMS the keyword Clover to 33650. That looks beautiful.
And also when you're kneading your dough, don't worry about over-kneading it, because normally a lot of people worry about over-kneading their dough because their bread tends to get dry and harder on the side.
Yes.
So now we're doing dombolo, so you don't have to worry about it. There's a lot of liquid that's steaming the bread, so it's going to be nice and soft on the inside.
Okay, whilst we're making our dombolo nice and soft, we're finishing off, of course, what we started before, which is our sheep head meat stew. Our stew looks brilliant. It looks like it's come together. The potatoes are soft. So whilst we are dishing up, I'm going to get the meat
And I
ready.
Love the idea of having the dombolo in that can. You know, we're using the tomato puree from Molise now, and we use the can to, you know, bake our bread in it, to steam our bread in it.
So not only did we use it, of course, for our canned goods, but now we just took off the label, we recycled it to make this cute. This is perfect for like a dinner party, I think. Very rustic, but beautiful.
You know,
too.
I don't know about you, but growing up, I was that kid who asked their friends to collect all of these cans and then we go to the bushes and cook. That's
and
how I started cooking.
It. Yeah. I love that. Oh, that's such a beautiful story, Aya. Whilst you're putting the meat, let me add idombolo. And this is filling, it is hearty, and it is perfect, of course, for the winter. Now, if you would like to try this recipe, SMS the keyword Clover to 33650. We asked you on our Twitter poll to let us know what you would shop for if you were to use your Manhattan dollars, of course. And here are some of the results. Thank you so much, Chef Aya. So we've asked you, between shoes, jewelry, fragrances, and vouchers, shoes and vouchers seem to be the top choice on our Twitter poll. A lot of people would use their Manhattan dollars, of course, to shop shoes and vouchers. Coming in behind by a huge long yard is, of course, fragrances. And last but not least is jewelry. So it looks like everyone has got their accessories out. They don't need jewelry, but what they do need, of course, are their shoes and vouchers with their Manhattan dollars. So here are the results, of course. Now, remember, the more you buy Manhattan, the more you can enter. And the more dollars you accumulate to shop online on the online store. Now, you can also stand a chance to win one of five shopping experiences worth 100,000 rands. And to get entering, the T's and C's apply.
It's an add to cart kind of day. So stand a chance to win your share of 1 million rand with Manhattan Iced Tea. Shop online in April and May at www.shopmanhattanstyle.co.za to be entered into the grand prize draw of a shopping experience in Sandton City. The winners will be announced on 5FM's Tabuti Drive in June. Buy any Manhattan 500ml or 1.5 litre promotional pack. Redeem your code from under the label and earn your virtual Manhattan dollars. Ready, set, shop.
So it's all things fashion after the break as we meet the designer and brand manager of the ageless fashion brand, Hugo Fleur. Now remember to connect with us on our social media platforms and tell us what your current favourite fashion trend is. Tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the official hashtag Afternoon Express or comment on our Facebook page.
To book your stay with SA's coolest hotel brand, visit protea.marriott.com today.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express. I hope that you're having a wonderful Thursday afternoon. Now, after gaining valuable knowledge about natural fibres like linen and cotton from working under a local designer, Hugo Fleur's first linen capsule range sold out within its first week. His extraordinary garments are loved for their unique prints on luxurious Italian linen, which is created in a modern yet classic style.
Absolutely. Now, he joins us in the loft with his partner and brand manager, Dennis Hammer, to share their journey from growing up in the Karoo Dorpi of Beaufort West to becoming the founders of his own fashion label, Hugo Fleur.
How are you? Welcome to
Thanks
the show.
For having us.
Thank you very much.
Wow. I love where you come from, you know, in the cop, because it basically sounds like one of those Funimava jokes in Funimavaville.
Yes. Yes.
So, what was your upbringing like?
I grew up in a very small town, Beaufort West. My mom was a single parent. Yeah. My brother and I used to go on weekend holidays. We went to my grandparents, Maribaville. And that's where I fundamentally taught myself to be self-reliant and also becoming a little bit of a loner back in the days.
Well, because you were probably the only person in Maribaville.
The only person there. And you have to use your imagination.
Exactly, but that's nice.
Yes.
And you've done that so beautifully, using your imagination, moving into the creative space and becoming a fashion designer. Where was your first interaction with fashion? And how did you find out that this is the route I want to go?
I first studied applied design, graphic design in Stellenbosch, and then I realized it's not my calling, I must change it. So I wanted to work with three-dimensional looks and the three-dimensional body and textile design. So I took out a loan and studied fashion design. And then part of the AFI group, the Fast Track group, I got a platform to showcase, and I got picked up by one of the big companies in Cape Town, and I designed for 2 years. And then I realized, well, I need to do something. I need to pay off my loan first and foremost and learn the market. Yeah. You must learn the market. And then in 2016, developed my own brand and developed from there.
Lovely. Now, the two of you are partners in business and in life.
Yes.
But now, how is it that you became the brand manager of Hugo Fleur?
Hugo's a little bit reserved, and yes. I've experience in sales.
Yes.
So he would do the designs, and I would take care of the ladies. Women love the personal attention when you dress them. And so come into our stall, and they would choose the wrong dress, the right colors, but the wrong dress for their body shapes. Ooh. And I will move them from the right thing. Or some people,
what to wear, yes.
Some people don't want to come into the stall, and I would say, you, my client, come in.
Yeah.
And at one of the festivals, we had the incident where the lady had these lace. And I said, no, please, lace is on for the windows. And even that insult, she bought two dresses from us. And now when she sees us at festival, she comes. This is the guy that said, I'm not allowed to wear lace.
Lace up for curtains. I can't believe you said that. But I'm sure this beautiful dynamic between you two, someone who's a bit more introverted and to himself compared to someone who is out there, will say it as it is, makes a beautiful collaboration.
Yes. And also, people need to buy in from us first before they buy the brand. So they must understand what we are and how, what we are presenting before they buy the collection.
Beautiful. So what are they buying? What is the essence of Hugo Fleur?
The essence is beauty. It's being ageless, being the best at whatever age you are. Dressing well, feeling confident, feeling you can get anything, even if you're 75, 65, doesn't matter what age you are.
That's Elon Musk's mom, no?
Deborah Chambers.
Oh, it looks like May Musk.
Yes.
Beautiful.
Yes, it does.
Absolutely beautiful.
It's Deborah Chambers from Johannesburg. She's a fantastic model. That's Ingrid Jones.
Love. Beautiful. Tell me about your use of the flowers. Why those particular prints?
I mean, we live in such a beautiful area in Cape Town. We are rich with the King Flora, the Proteas, the Silitias. Have you moved back to the Karoo? You've got your aloes.
Yeah.
Yes. So we must enhance that. Take it and present it to the world. We've got the base around us.
Your collection is so beautiful, so I don't think we can hold back anymore. You've got to see this and enjoy it. I mean, hello. I mean, just
gorgeous.
Such beautiful, rich colors, and such great structure. Tell us a little bit about this outfit.
It's a beautiful fitted silhouette. Linen can also be a little bit more sexy. You don't have to be oversized. But
I die for those earrings as well. You look gorgeous.
And then the coat is there just to be for a little bit of a warmth, more of a feminine touch. Yeah. It's softer fabrics.
And I love how, you know, people shy away from prints because they think prints could be an overkill. You have balanced it out perfectly with having the lower half being the emphasis on the print and the shape of a woman and the curves and balancing it out with the white.
Yes, always keep the face white.
Yes.
Okay,
to enhance the features and then let the print flow to the bottom.
I mean, this is just so beautiful, so elegant. I love the brightness and the you know, the colors are
the
just
deep,
amazing.
Rich color.
Can we just say how beautiful your models are?
Yeah, I don't think we've had
stunning.
Such great
They're
models
stunning,
in here
stunning,
for a long
stunning.
Time. I mean, during the commercial break, I said, Hugo, you always find the best and most beautiful models. And Hugo and Dennis Burr said, no, they find us.
They find us.
You
they
are,
do.
You
they
are
do.
The magnet. This is stunning. And I know that you also created the shoes or designed the
shoes.
We
do, yes, we do. That's, and this is part of the company. So he manufactures the it's proudly South African fallies.
Beautiful.
It's loafers.
Because our women like to have flat shoes,
yes,
because they don't, high heels not always comfortable. And we have a memory foam inside so they can stand 24 hours on those shoes without hurting their feet.
That is genius. I need to get myself some fillies, especially on a busy day on the show when I'm running between the kitchen and the lounge.
Stunning.
Oh, that is just so elegant. You know what I love about it? If you do put on a heel, you can take day and night.
Exactly.
I mean, it's
you
just
can
so
wear it
fabulous.
Up or down. It's easy.
And the raincoats are not only waterproof, the raincoats is windproof. So it's a thin coat, but it's very light, but it's very warm because it keeps the wind out.
This sounds like something that I need to get for not only my mom, but for every other woman in my life. Of course, we just come from Mother's Day. But
my mom would go mad for this.
I love this. This is too brilliant. And I like also that you've played on activewear.
Yes,
the red touch. The attention to
detail. It's easy wear, it's linen.
Sure, but you know what I really appreciate about your collection and your style is I think, you know, a woman at any age must dress every day.
Exactly.
Always, I mean, never fear, even if you're going to the supermarket, put on a red lip.
Yes.
Put on something fabulous.
Show where you are.
Put on those hoops, honey, and rock out. I love this look. I love the collection. Oh. I love the use of Italian fabrics. Just so easy and comfortable. Thank you so much.
We're just totally celebrating how fabulous you ladies are. Well done. Thank you for being here today. How gorgeous.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for sharing your absolute beautiful talents
with us.
Thanks
for having me.
And what a great collection. Well done.
Thank you.
Bravo indeed. I love it. Now, after the break, Dladla Mshunqisi shakes up the loft with an energetic performance. See you after that. I'm ready.
Check it handheld. 1 2 1 2 1 2. You're coming through.
Hey.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express, of course, where we are ushering the weekend a little day early, of course, with Dladla Mshunqisi. Where can people find you this weekend?
This weekend, Gise Ayep, and then there's obviously Festival Rocks coming up. Durban July.
Durban rocks for the Durban July. I'm looking forward to it. I will be front row shouting out, Hugo Fleur. Thank you so much. Now, wherever you go, Dladla's music can be heard blasting through the speakers on dance floors and events countrywide, making him one of the best hit makers in the country right now. Performing a mashup of a song called Torta and Bagisha, it's Dladla Mshunqisi, ladies and gentlemen. Chisa!
Dancers are unbelievable.
Yeah.
Wow, imagine doing exercises with them.
Because,
I mean, the thighs must be rock hard.
They're everything. I am
goals,
sweating.
What is goals?
forever.
Well, look, done, girls, you're amazing.
On social media, we've been asking you to interact with us and engage whilst I catch my breath, Jeannie. Yo, I was losing my mind there for a second. But what I love, one of our viewers, of course, said a shout out, a huge, major shout out to Dladla, of course, because he definitely collaborated on a song called Memeza. Yeah. And that song, Memeza, became a call to action against woman abuse, child amazing. Abuse, which we absolutely love. The music video echoes that. So we all stand together, Siti Memeza, let's all stand behind women abuse and child abuse, of course. But lovely. I love Dladla Mshunqisi. What a throwback. Yo,
I don't know if I've ever seen you so excited in this
lab. It's too much. Yo.
Tomorrow we meet super talented, up-and-coming hip-hop artist Nyota Parker. That's also going to be amazing.
Yeah.
So thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. It was wonderful sharing our time with you.
Yes.
So we'll see you again tomorrow, same time, same place. Good night and God bless. Mwah.
Happy eating, yo.
Afternoon Express, made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.